How you guys doing?
Brother?
What's that?
You remember me?
Yeah.
Hey, man.
How you been?
Hi.
You're Nicole?
Yes.
Okay. What's going on?
So, my friend, we were out of town for a business trip this weekend.
Right.
And I dropped her off at 2 o'clock this morning. She's 15 weeks pregnant. She wasn't feeling well. And she had a doctor's appointment this morning at 9, and I told her to let me know if she needed me to take her. She's got two little girls. And she was very distraught over the weekend, wasn't eating normally or drinking, and we kept trying to force it on her because she's pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
Her husband and her supposedly are separating, but she didn't know this. She thought they were just having issues. He disclosed that to me today.
Okay.
Because I called him, and I was like, have you talked or heard from Shannan since you left for work this morning? Because I can't get a hold of her. I've called. I've texted. Her car's in the garage. Her shoes she wears every single day are by the front door.
She only has one vehicle?
No, they only have the one vehicle and a work truck.
Okay, that's what I'm asking. There's not a...
She took the girls and went on a play date, but they're 4 and 2. She went on a play date? Why wouldn't she take in a car? They're both in car seats. And she had a doctor's appointment this morning at 9, and she didn't go to the doctor's appointment.
Okay, no answer on the phone. Husband's on his way.
Supposedly, but he said that 30 minutes ago, and when I called him again, he said he was 45 minutes out, so... And I know the code to the door.
You do?
I do, but there's a thing on it. There's a... No, it'll... Even Chris, I'm going to do it. There's a... They have the thing flipped up here.
Oh. What about the garage door?
I don't know.
Is there... do you mind calling him and seeing if we can get a passcode to this and get my get me permission to go in?
Okay.
I'm just going to check the back, see if I can see anything. Right. I just want to look in all the windows, make sure I don't see anything out of... Do they? Oh, it doesn't?
Yep, so they're gonna have tarp on that one and tarp on the one over there too. At least they should have one on unless you see signs of...
Yep, I've got to have more unless I get consent from him to go in. Because it could be grandparents came and picked him up. You know, it could be a lot of things. She left her phone, her phone's dead.
And it doesn't change anything even if they are pregnant?
No, I mean...
It's different rules, but they're all about...
Yeah, you've got your 4th Amendment rights to the house. I can't violate that. That's why. No, not. I mean, if I saw her laying on the ground, something like that.
You saw signs of a fight or anything.
Kids were. I could get a hold of the kids. No, mom's not answering.
Can't do much.
I got nothing right now though. How you doing? You seen your neighbors today? No. Okay. Oh, we're just trying to get a hold of her. Sounded like she wasn't feeling too good and pregnant, and they were just concerned.
No, I know he works in the oil field, but he's on certain days and off for...
You didn't see her today, though, any outside or anything?
I didn't
see
her at all.
Okay.
That's not anything
more. Right. Thank you.
honestly, that's out of the ordinary. Usually, when it's not out, it usually doesn't come out.
How am I gonna get in?
Yeah, I think she's diabetic, to be honest with you. Something with his blood sugar, I
thought. He said the same thing. Yeah. My mom knows. So, is there a key code, Sammy, to open the garage from the outside? What is it? His mom's gonna get it.
Okay.
This is her parents.
Mike, what's the key code of the garage? Danny's house. The cops are there.
Well, I can't go in, but if they allow you to go in, I have to have the property owner's permission to enter.
Something's going on.
Okay. Well, he's the property owner.
Well, they called me. Shannan was at her girlfriend's house.
Do we know who that is?
Do we know who?
Her phone number?
He didn't say.
When did he tell you that?
He needs Mrs. Jackson's money. I don't get it. What did he say?
He told me that Shannan didn't take the girls to school this morning because she was going to go on a play date, but her car's here.
What's Chris's phone number?
It's, they have the top lock, the one that they have on there, so Cece can't escape. Chris's phone number is 910-309-1702.
Okay, that was Chris, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey Chris, Officer Coonrod for the police department.
Hey,
pretty good. So, do you have any idea where your wife is? Okay. Right. What my concern is, her car's here. They're saying she is diabetic. I don't want her, if she's upstairs and can't respond. Okay. About how far out are you? Okay. All right. Thanks. Dispatch, Rec 981. He states medical. This female is diabetic. Unknown if she is home, though. Husband is on his way.
Did he say how long you're taking to get
here? He said like 5 minutes. So he's about here.
So he's told us 4 to 5 minutes 2 times in a row. So he told one of my mom's friends that he was on I-45, so the interstate pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
And we waited the time we were told, the mom called again. He said he was still on it and to wait another 45 minutes. So he's just been giving us false times and everything. And we know he's been lying because his stories aren't adding up.
Right.
He tell everybody different stories.
And do we have, like, her parents' phone numbers or anything we can call them to make sure?
She's not close to
him. Oh, she's not?
Not that. No, okay. She still talks to him and everything.
Well, I was just thinking maybe they were watching the kids or she was visiting them or they don't. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I mean, I don't see anything out of place. I'm not hearing kids. I'm not hearing anything.
Yeah, and all of her stuff is here, and I set off the alarm by trying to open the garage forcefully, and that didn't work. So. And their alarm's one of the ones where it goes off and it feels like it's making your ears bleed.
Mm-hmm.
So if she was in there.
She should have heard it.
Yeah, she would have while she was sleeping because they have little things on the wall on every room to go off.
What's Shannan's number?
It's 910.
Man, I set up the alarm. I'm assuming you probably know how loud the alarm's
going. It's pretty loud.
Sorry.
That's kind of weird.
And the light upstairs.
850-3286.
Phone ring or anything.
Yeah, man. The neighbor has a camera system.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, because we have one story, she's with a friend right now, and then there's another story, she's on a play date with her kids with another friend, and then she left in the middle of the night. So he told us 3 different stories. So the neighbor over there said he has a camera that sees out on the street. So, sorry. We asked him if he could see if he was able to see if she ever left the house.
All right, that'll work.
You got in someone else's car.
Shannan, are you home? Police department, if anyone's inside, make yourself known. Police department, if anyone's inside, make yourself known. I think they were here, the kids or someone would respond though. You'd hear some kind of noise.
When did you talk to her last, Sandy?
How are you doing? Scott, how you doing?
How's it going?
So this is the only vehicle she would have?
Only one that, yeah.
She would drive? Okay.
That's me. Yeah. The neighbors went and checked his camera and they said that a white car drove away at 1. It was me, though. That was me. I dropped her off.
That was the last action on my camera.
Okay. That's throughout the whole day, or?
Besides Chris leaving?
Well, yeah.
What about the, do you know there's no way you can look for the day? During the daytime?
So she left with the friend, she would have took the car seats.
I can go look if he doesn't find
her. Yeah, if you don't mind.
Okay.
Huh? Chris is in the house. We're standing outside with the police officer. Can we go in the house?
We can.
I mean, that's up to him. It's his house. If he goes.
Nikki, I'm giving you permission to walk in my daughter's house.
Mind if I come in, Chris?
Okay.
You checked upstairs? She's not there? I just want to make sure she's not passed out somewhere. Is she diabetic? You mind if I look around?
Go ahead.
Go ahead. Thanks. it for. I'm checking the house for consent.
Down the phone.
Oh. Well, shoot. Any friends you know she would be hanging out with?
I mean,
I know. I guess her
Amanda,
her parents are out of state.
Across country, North Carolina.
Oh.
Yeah, so that's not happening. She can play. All the girls blankies are gone. Their blankies they sleep with. They don't leave anywhere without them.
Good. Nothing else appears to be missing, though. Just
no,
stuff you'd take for a quick trip. Does she work?
Yeah, she works from home.
Oh, from home?
She works, this is her lifeline. So, yeah, that thing turns back on, it's going to start blowing up.
Oh, yeah. Trust me. It was shut down?
She's in the flyer. Yeah. It used to be 2385, but now it's 6 digits.
It's the baby's due date.
1-31-8-19.
What does she do for work?
She works a direct sales company called Drive.
How often does her blood sugar drop low?
Cassie, her friend in Arizona said that that's the first time it's ever happened.
She normally has migraines, like, a while ago, but she had them a lot this weekend.
Yeah.
And Cassie's a nurse, so she figured it was because her blood pressure sugar was dropping.
Yeah.
Because she wasn't eating her normal that she normally eats. Like, she'd take a couple bites until she was full.
Okay.
And she
doesn't ever black out or have seizures or anything like that?
No, I mean, long time ago. She had a car wreck, and they believe that's what happened. But Imitrex is something she takes for migraine. She took more Imitrex this last month than she ever had before, but that's just because she was in North Carolina with the humidity and everything like that. She was there for 6 weeks, and we got back Monday or Tuesday, and then she flew out to Arizona Friday morning, and then she got back last night about 2 a.m. Flight got delayed. She left about 11. She got here at 2.
Okay.
And I went to work this morning about 5:15, 5:30.
What do you do?
I work at oil and gas and Anadarko.
What do you do for them?
Operator.
Oh. Long days then?
Yeah, I'd definitely still be out there.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's always a long day, especially in that heat. There's no, off text messages.
Can you look at your camera to see from your security system to see when she left?
It's mostly left out the front door.
Because you told me that she went on a play date with the girls. And then
that's what she told me.
Addy said you told her that
she went with some friends. She went to go to a friend's house with the kids.
Well,
that's why I knew they weren't at school.
Addy said you told her that she left in the middle of the night.
Oh, no, she didn't leave in the middle of the night, no.
Yeah.
Where do your kids go to school at?
Primrose in Vista Ridge.
Daniel,
Hey. Yeah. No. Yeah, she said she was at a friend's house. That's what she told me she was going to do.
Nicholas.
I have no clue at whatsoever why she wouldn't take her cell phone. No, it doesn't make any sense at all.
She didn't leave out the front door against you.
What? Hey, yeah, I can look at that and see. But it's so random because it goes off and on here lately. It gets false trips because they told me it was open when I got here.
I know it doesn't make any sense at all.
I'm not lost. I don't know where she's at, where the kids are at. Yeah. Only people that are out of state that she would contact would be in Arizona, be passing God, and they're not there.
Neighbor, he has cameras. He said that the only people that left the house were you in the morning and then drove a shot at
him. That's all he has.
I dropped her off.
Okay. But who left and injured?
Okay.
I'll see if I can get on that USA app or Chase app. See if I can get on that, please. I'll see. I will. Alright, here's Nicky.
Dispatch, Rec 91. You can cancel medical if they're staged.
First is the last person who wants to go.
So what time do you work?
Usually, once I get to work, it's like 6:30 to 3:30, 4 o'clock.
You usually work nights or days?
Days.
What time do you leave the day?
What time do I leave there?
Here.
Usually between 5:30 and 6.
All right. And was Shannan here then?
Yes. Yeah, well, she was still in bed.
Does she usually watch the kids, or do you have daycare watch them?
She usually watches the kids if they're not at school.
Okay. Center thing right here.
There's a pool right down there.
Yeah.
I mean, I've been here for like off and on for 3 hours. There's nothing there.
Alright, I can run down there and check.
You guys have any kind of issues? Marital issues or?
We're going through separation.
You are? Did you guys file yet or anything, or just talking about?
No, we're going to sell the house and do a separation.
And how's that going?
It's going
civil for the most part, or? that swimming pool often, or?
It just depends. I mean, on a hot day like this, I would say no. At 5:27 a.m., the overhead garage door 2 was left open and never shut. About that time. So either like when I pulled away and shut the door, it never shut. It was shut when you got here.
Yeah.
So either the sensor was tripping out, which has happened before, so I had to replace it 2 weeks ago. Before I left. The basement door was left open at 5:26. Visitor checked at 1:48, that's when she got home. And then the visitor checked at 12:10, that was when she came.
You able to pull up the video at the 12:10? See, was it front
at
door?
At 12:10, that was Nikki.
That was you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Ed was beeping at me at the out in the field.
Does she do her work from a laptop, or is it just
phone.
From the phone?
Just from the phone.
What about your bank account?
I tried her logins are different than mine. I don't.
It's not a joint account.
It's a joint account, but like she controls all of it. Like she doesn't let me do the finances because I was pretty horrible back in the day. So she just kind of handles all that and she does it. And I have the apps on my phone, but I don't have her login to get into it.
Okay.
Unfortunately, that's.
Can you log into your account though?
I can. No, I don't have like a laptop, but she has the one down there. So, but her login is different. Her login, I don't know her login. Like I know the password, but I don't know her login for user ID. It's always the same password, 428-195 capital SW. But it's just a matter of getting the login.
So you
should
have first show
back to right, if she's getting gas or
yeah, somewhere.
What days does she typically do work?
Every day.
Every day?
Yeah, always.
What was the name of the company again?
LeVell. L-E-V-E-L.
they based out of?
Texas. But they don't have like a... They don't have like an office. It's just...
Does she have someone that she reports to, though?
She has her leaders, but they're both in northeast part of the country. Like that. She has Addie Maloney. She has Amanda Aikman. She has... Sam Paisley.
Okay. What, do you have her phone number?
Addie?
Yeah. What'd you say her last name was? And there was no note or anything by the wedding ring? Is any of her clothes, anything like that, missing? It didn't look like she went through and packed up bag or anything.
No, I mean, she has this and all that on the bottom, so it'd be kind of hard to tell if she took a little bit or, I mean, it'd be easy to tell if she took a lot, but it's hard to tell if she took a little bit or not.
Okay. Did she tell you anything about leaving, moving out?
Not moving out. I mean, the last time I talked to her was this morning. She said she was going to take the kids to a friend's house, and that's where she was going to be. And then I've texted her today. I've never heard anything, but the car's here. Unless somebody came and picked her up. But the people that I know, nobody's heard from her, nobody's seen her.
Right. Who do you guys bank with?
Chase and USAA.
Definitely an odd one.
I don't know what I can do right now, but drive around like the normal route that she would be.
Where does she normally go to?
I mean, just like drive where like she would normally take the kids to school. People that I know that live down, Kristen lives down that way. I mean, that's the only routes I know she would really take.
She go to their house frequently, or?
And not much, but. Hey, I'm still talking to the officer right now. Okay, bye. I will, definitely. Bye bye. Sorry about that. How's your mom? I mean, you think it's smart just to go just drive around and see if I mean.
Probably not, because, I mean, you don't know what car she's in, where she's at. I mean, obviously, you're not going to see her car. It's here.
I know Amanda's out of town because her brother died, and she's not flying back till today. And the other one she's really close with that I know is Sarah.
Who else do you think I could do?
Yeah.
Just wait for her here?
Up here?
Well, I've got my detective coming,
okay.
Just because this is kind of an odd situation. So we can try to get her pinpointed down, find a friend or something.
Okay.
He may have you call the bank.
Okay. Hey, sir, it's Chris Watts. Not too bad. Have you heard from Shannan today? No, I have not. I was just, you're my last person to call. So I just, all right. make you nervous or anything, but I'll keep you posted. No. Okay, thank you. Bye.
Not there. And she lives around here?
She lives in Aurora.
Aurora.
You okay?
Yeah.
I don't want to answer. Yes. She's smelly. She do funny? You need a new diaper?
Yeah.
How long you been in oil field?
Since 2015, Anarcho 2015 January, Covenant year before that. After that, I worked on cars for 11 years.
You liking it?
I love the fact that I don't have to get carpal tunnel on my wrist. That's what I left it for, left the car business for.
Right.
Because it was just around my body. The oil field is less repetitive as far as the same stuff over and over, just doing that all the time.
Right.
A lot of lifting, but other than that, it's perfect for what I do. It gives me time with the kids. I used to be on 8 days on, 6 days off. But now I'm on 5 and 2, so let's go back to 8 and 6 next month. So I'll be getting a lot more time with the kids. That's what I'm excited about.
Right.
Get for a break.
Do you have any medical conditions other than
lupus? Fibromyalgia, rosacea. Thought she had RA, but she took a lot of medication in North Carolina. She stopped a bunch of it when she moved here, but she has some flare-ups here and there.
When did she move here?
She moved here in 2012.
Okay. No, is she taking any kind of medication?
Imitrex for migraines and some Monte Cuclast for allergies and stuff like that.
Okay.
And some stuff for nausea.
No, nothing's changed as far as medication-wise?
No, not that I know of, not that she said.
Any kind of behavioral changes, anything like that recently?
Going through a separation, that's the only behavior changes I've seen. Just a little emotional.
Okay. So I might be there in just a minute.